Welcome back. Melody Chronister here. As you can tell, I am feeling a whole lot better and I'm ready to show you how to add videos, audio. We're going to add a poster and a fallback image to our video and we're going to add some captions. So let's get this party started. Now, with publishing audio and video content, we have to keep in mind a few main concepts: encoding and containers. The process of transforming a moving image or a sound like a digital file is known as encoding. Video and audio can be encoded in many different ways, and researchers are continually trying to find out new ways to encode video that doesn't take so long to load. Now, each encoding method is known as a codec, short for coder or decoder. There are four main video codecs that are in use widely on the web today. And that includes the H.264, Theora, VP8, VP9. Now, for video, codecs are not the end of the story because video is most often accompanied by audio. And that's where the whole container concept comes into play because you have a container that includes the video and the audio content. There are several container formats out there, and this is where you'll be like, oh, okay, I know what these are. You have the MP4, most common, or MPEG-4, the OGG, OGG, the WebM, and the Flash Video. Now, Flash is slowly dying on the vine there because of the proprietary software. You need a plugin in order to play, which is also referred to as a helper program. But with the others, you don't. The new modern web browsers play MP4s, OGGs, and WebM videos straight in the browser without requiring a download or a plugin to be installed. Now, one more little tidbit of information before we actually dive in and get our hands dirty with some code. The MPG4, that actually stands for Moving Pictures Experts Group. That's where the MPEG comes in. They also developed the MP3 for the audio component. And the VP8, VP9, that's Google. Because, you know, Google practically owns the planet, right? Okay, but enough about that. I know you want to just see the code. I have some videos. I want to add them. Show me how, Melody. Let's do it. So I created a bucket here. And literally, folks, all I did is I copied this code here for this div. And then I pasted it here and changed the text. And we're going to put a video right up here above where it says for more, check out my YouTube channel. And then you may or may not have noticed the back to top buttons. I moved those because I was like, why am I saying back to top when they're barely scrolling? I moved it down to the bottom. And once again, I just threw it in a div. And then I added that gradient that we covered in a recent video. If you haven't checked it out, be sure to do it. So with that said, let's actually add some video content. I'm going to dive into my HTML here. We're going to find that div that I created. And see, here it is. It says, here is a recent video on how to add favicons to my website. And I even left a blank space for us to put it in. So I am going to just move on up. And then to add a video, I'm going to just do the bracket, type in the word video, space, source. So similar to adding an image. And within the quotes, then you put the path for your file. Now, I created a media folder to put my stuff in. And when I type in /media in Aptana, it does show the files in that folder. So I'm looking for the MP4. There it is. And then that's it for that one. But before we close this out, we need to put a type. So type equals, and this is video/MP4 in quotes. And then if we want them to have controls so that they can press play, pause it, stop it, change the volume, we need to type in the word controls. Otherwise, they will not be able to control that video. And then close your bracket and close the video bracket. So let's go ahead and save that and see what that looks like. Go in here, refresh, and you'll notice something. Look, it's big. It's bigger than the website itself. That's not going to be very fun. How the heck am I supposed to have my viewers view that? Because we have to get CSS involved. So let's dive into our styles here. Scroll all the way up. And then here where we had our images, max width 100% of the screen, we need to go ahead and add that video element in as well in order for that same rule to be applied. And then in our reset styles, we're going to want to add that there too. And these two steps are going to make a world of difference. So let's save that, go in, refresh. Ah, much better, right? So now it fits in my screen. See the controls here at the bottom? Those are going to look slightly different depending on the browser you're using. I'm using Chrome. So if we click play really quick here, we'll see that it starts playing the video, which is neat. But I did notice that when, here, let's refresh. Look at this. Isn't it kind of ugly? When they scroll down to this, I don't want them to just see a big gray square. I want a thumbnail. So let's go ahead and add a thumbnail in here. Now to do that, That's in our HTML here. So we're going to go to, here's our video. We're going to go ahead and at the end of where it says controls, we're going to put in a space. And then we're going to type in poster equals and then the image path. So I still put the poster in my media folder. So I'm going to type media slash. And the name of this one is favicons.png. And it's that simple to put in a poster. However, hold up. Let's say the video does not load for some reason. It's not working. Well, we would like an image to show up in the event this doesn't work so that our placement in our website still looks the way we want it to. So in between these two brackets here, I'm going to open that up. So I'm within my video brackets and I'm going to put in the word object. Open that up. And within object, I'm going to put in an image. So this would be termed as a fallback image. And it's image source. And then it's the same image, media slash favicons, favicon.png, extra S there. There we go. And then we want to put in our alt text for our images so that if a screen reader is using it, it knows what it is. And I'm going to say poster of favicon icons and then close that out. So let's save this and see what this looks like. Go in here, refresh. Oh, much better. So see, now when they scroll down, they see this adding favicons poster. And if for some reason the video didn't load, it would still show the image, which is good. Now we need to add the captions to our video. Very important, because what if they can't hear, right? We want them to be able to read the response. Some of us just prefer to read captions because we can better understand what the presenter is trying to get across. To add captions, it's actually another language called WebVTT. WebVTT is its own markup language for creating text tracks that accompany video. Now, quick tip here. YouTube has a fabulous captioning program. So if you upload your video there and you click to add subtitles, it will try to automatically do it. It's pretty close. You can just fix a word here or there. And then you can export that file. And guess what? It's a WebVTT file. So if you don't want to build these yourself, just know there's programs out there that can build them for you. So I actually have a file already ready to go for this video. I exported this from YouTube. So as you can see, it's a pretty simplistic language. I know you see a lot of numbers, but that's all timestamps. And then you'll notice here, what's up, guys? That's what I said at the beginning of the video. So we have our file there. So now we just need to point to it in our HTML. And to do that, we're going to still be above our closing video tag. And then we're going to add in the tag track source. And then in parentheses, we're going to click media slash, and then we should see it, captions.vtt. And then we need to tell it the kind, the attribute kind, and it's captions. And then source language, so S-R-C-L-A-N-G equals, and it's English, it's E-N. And then label, English captions. And close that bracket here. Now, warning, captions do not work on your local computer, which means you do have to put these files on a web server in order to test it out. Notice up here, I'm on my local computer. So let me use some video magic, and when we come back, it will be up on the server. Whew! I hope you had a great trip jumping to the future. So I have put this site on a web server. So you'll notice the web address is actually a real web address and not on a local computer this time. So if we scroll down to the video, now we will click the CC here. Let's hit play, and let's see these captions that we just uploaded go to work. And see, there you go. So it's starting to read the captions. So it worked. Woohoo! And if you haven't checked out that favicons video, I suggest you do so. It's a fun one. So we've talked about how to add video. We've added a poster. We've added a fallback. We've added captions. So now let's talk about adding audio. I'm going to go ahead and stick some audio up here below our first paragraph. And it's very similar to the video concept, but this time we just type in the word audio. And then if we want them to see controls so they can control whether to turn it off and on, etc. Then we again type in the word controls, and then I'm going to open that up, and then I'm going to put in source SRC equals, and then the path for our audio. So I have a MP3 here called Funky, royalty free music, and then the type this time is audio, and then the type of file is MPEG. Don't forget to put those in quotes as I almost did. Awesome, close it. Now it's always a good idea to have some fallback. So if you have multiple versions, let's say you had an OGG file or an OGG file, we could always add multiple lines of source code. So I could literally type this whole line again, but put OGG type audio/OGG, and then it would try to play that one first, and if it didn't work, then it would play this one. We would stack it. But in this case, I just have the one audio, so we're going to go with that. If you do just go with one, MP4 for video, MP3 for audio is the way to go. It's the most universally accepted across browsers. And before we check it out, let's jump into our CSS here. And in our main content styles, I'm just going to scroll down here to the bottom of that, and I'm going to add audio, and then I'm just going to give it a margin. Otherwise, it's going to look really funny within that div. A margin is auto, so I'm going to center it, and from the top, I'm going to go 10. Okay, now let's, for our reset styles. Hold on, I almost forgot. We're going to want to add audio to our reset styles here, and let's refresh and see what it looks like. I'm going to scroll up. So see right here, it added the audio bar. I know, it doesn't look great. In fact, I want to grab this blank paragraph I had here. I want to stick it above the audio. And in previous videos, if you're wondering what this is, and in BSP is one of those character references that equals a space in HTML. So it's just literally blank space. Nothing you'll see on this end. Oh, much better. So I added the blank space here and it centered it because now it's treating it as its separate paragraph. Beautiful. And if we click play here, we'd hear some pretty neat music if I didn't have headphones plunked in. So that's one way to do it. Now let's say you wanted music to play in the background on your website when people visit. First, I want to caution you about that. I know it is pretty cool to have music playing in the background, but I encourage you to put controls somewhere on your site like this, because if you take the controls away, the only way they can control the volume is if they think to just use their volume knob on their computer, and they might not be in a place where they want the sound, right? They might be in a library, they might be at work. If they come across your site and immediately it starts generating noise, they might immediately close it. So keep that in mind depending on who your target audience is. You may or may not want to have music playing automatically. But if you do, you just go in here and delete the word controls. If we do that and we refresh, it controls disappear. They don't see anything, but they hear it. The music will just be playing in the background until it's done. If you want it to continue to play, then you would just hit space and then you would just type in the word loop. And that would keep playing the music until they disappear. So when in doubt, add controls. And that does it today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. If you have any questions, comment down below. Next week, we get to talk about programming web pages with some JavaScript, which is very exciting. Stay tuned for that. Until then, stay cool, stay happy, and I will see you later.